thank all the members of the media for joining us this evening. Just wanted to convey that earlier this afternoon I met with Coach Ben Howland. We had a nice conversation about the program and a number of things, and subsequent to that discussion, I informed him that we were relieving him of his duties as a head coach at UCLA, and that we would be moving forward.
It always takes a while. Yeah, it always takes a while. I mean, we've had very few freshmen that have shown up, you know, that were just ready, you know, and it starts with their, you know, depending on where they're from. Like, Bamute was, you know, probably in the Flalo were probably the two most exceptional freshman defenders that I've coached. They were able, and they still made mistakes. But, you know, I think back especially to Luke. I mean, you know, to do what he did as a freshman and play at such a high level and be so good eventually is really a rarity. It's the exception to the rule. I mean, most players are coming in and have a lot to learn. We have very high expectations at UCLA. That goes without saying. That's why I wanted to be the coach here. I love those expectations. I think it drives your players to be the best they can be, to always have expectations that you're supposed to win every time you play. And it drives you to get better. And I think our kids have really improved a lot over the course of the season. We still have a long way to go. I'm really feel good and confident about our team.
both teams out of timeouts. Gonzaga in the double bonus, UCLA shooting 1-1. Zags with the 71-68 lead after leading big in the first half, 37-20. Adam Morrison has 24 points. Coach Howland's team, though, continues to fight. They've got to play serious defense for the next 26 seconds and try to keep this a one-possession game. They give it to the All-America, Morrison in the backcourt. And he quickly gets it over the midcourt line. Hands it off to Rivio, the point guard. They give it to Morrison, guarded by Farmer. Step back jumper deep, off the heel. Loose ball, and a foul! On who? It will go, I believe, against Batista. Not a bad man to foul. Holland, a 60% free throw shooter. 1-1 against the Bulls. 71-69.
Well, the problem is UCLA, if they make a miss, they've got a foul. Instead of making a good stop and getting an opportunity to shoot the three for the tie.
Second free throw good. 71-70. So even with two made free throws, UCLA will still have a chance if they can rebound to tie this game up. Pendergraft, the inbounder on the baseline.
And the only guy that you might take a foul on is Jeremy Pargo at 69%.
They throw it to Morrison. He holds on.
We don't want to foul Morrison. You make him get it over half court. You know you got to foul.
And a steal! Farmer! Inside! The freshman up! Has climbed the mountain. Bozeman, a Flalo foul with 1.9 to go. And he will shoot two. Adam Morrison, is this it for him? After leading the entire ball game, the nation's number two scorer went down earlier. Now Adam Morrison.
Left the door open for a miracle on Perk.
And they got to put it in the hands of Morrison. Second free throw is good. Hollis comes into the game. He'll guard the ball. Pendergraft, the inbounder.
Any long pass, trying to get it to half court, you still want to go after the ball like you're a corner.
And a good court. Batista with the catch.
And
that's
it. What a comeback.
As I mentioned, you've seen so many of these shots get hit because you don't go after the ball aggressively. That time Batista still makes the catch.
you know, there's been so many great moments. I don't know if there's the best, but I guess that if I was sitting there, I would say the Gonzaga win is probably the one that would come to mind first. Being down 17 to 10 to go, with, you know, whatever being a national championship final game before losing to Florida. And then as a coach, you always remember the losses way better than you do the wins. So that would be the just get me after and we can talk for an hour.
To stop the clock and get on the free throw line. I caught what you said. That didn't go over my head.
Just have a little fun.
We got the last.
We
got
to keep it live with the Iranians.
Last 20 seconds. Love going to fire the three. Yes. Trying to draw the foul. Hit the three. Makes it a one. Got a foul quickly. Anderson. They go for the steal. Now it's Bruin basketball.
Foul.
No foul is called.
Are
in the corner.
Me?
Bruins have got it. 15 seconds down one. Ben Bruin can't. Believe it.
Pauley Pavilion magic and back-to-back games. That was clearly a downward hack. Usually that's an automatic call when you have the downward swipe over the arms and hands. Now, granted, Ryan Anderson should have secured the ball.
Here comes Westbrook. Final 14. Bruins trailing by one.
Hollywood sprint, Brent.
For the win. Collison short. Shipp's underneath. The ball was caught by Cal with 6 seconds to go. They give it back to UCLA.
It's better than Hoosiers, the picket fence. Where's that? Where's it?
Here come the inbounds now. Shipp maneuvering, driving.
Thank you. Jamal Boykin got there, and he just got a face plant from Westbrook.
Jamal got Boykin'd.
He got us. So maybe we're saying today that's called being YouTubed.
Wow.
Getting off his feet a lot quicker and a lot higher on the release point.
Another Cougar turnover. Westbrook! Another entry for U2. Westbrook, and that's got Washington State calling timeout. UCLA has taken Washington State out of its game in the first 6 minutes.
Their defense has been the key. Their defense needs the turnovers, needs the transition opportunity, a little double clutch. Allow Kyle Weaver to fly by and then throw it down with two hands. Watch a little double clutch here. Here's Weaver. Oh, bring it down a little bit and then hang in the air and switch it to the right hand at the last moment on the expo. Russell Westbrook is a beauty.
Really not interested in who scores. All he cares about is winning. He came back when he could have gone to the NBA last year to lead this team to winning, and it's really you can see his maturity, and you know that he knows he's our best player. He's our most important guy out there, night in, night out. Defense starts with him. Offense starts with him, and I think he's getting a lot of joy. And you look at his 10 assists, the one turnover. And the one turnover, he was trying to just throw a pass a little too far to Josh. And it wasn't a terrible turnover because he was really trying to get his teammate the ball.
Yeah, it was really special, and for me in particular, I'm really disappointed I didn't get to be out there. Jamal was one of my heroes growing up. I'm a little kid in Santa Barbara, Galena, California, and the big star at the local high school was senior year after moving up from Ventura is Keith Wilkes. And then when he went on to UCLA, I watched all their games, and what a great player. The guy was, unbelievable. Athlete, player, smart, skilled, four NBA championships. He was part of a team of 60-0 over the year. First team All-American, academic All-American. And he's such a classy guy. I don't even know Jamal. But what a class act. And so I heard it was really nice and really well done. And I was really happy to hear that. And Simon Sinon, his daughter, everybody was here. to be able to help him celebrate that. Now he's had to get the jersey retired in the last month, both at, with the Lakers and with UCLA. That's pretty special. It doesn't get much better than that.
Josh, just reflecting on your 4 years here at UCLA, what do you think was your favorite memory?
Probably the Cal game when I hit that buzzer beater. It was just a special game. It was a big time shot, and I had a lot of fun in that game.
And what do you think was your individual best performance out of all your
players? I think I had a few, but I think today was a good one. It was a great way to leave my last game at Poly, career high, so I'm happy with that one.
And what were some of the things that were going through your head as you were in the tunnel for the last time?
It's tough. I didn't really think about it too much. I'm sure I'll reminisce later on today in the next few weeks. But, we had a game, so I was focused on that, just trying to win that game.
And what about the atmosphere, Paulie? Are you going to miss the most?
Definitely going to miss it. The fans, they were huge for us, like six men out there. They did a great job of supporting me. Just want to thank all the fans.
Reflecting on your 4 years here at UCLA, what do you think was your favorite memory out of all 4 years?
Without question, the trip to the Final Four. We've been there 3 straight years, and just having that success on the court, it means a lot to me. Because I know there aren't that many college players that can say that they've been to the Final Four 3 straight times, and I was part of it, and that's the most memorable thing that I lived through my UCLA career.
And what do you think was your best individual performance?
The one that I can remember now is against Notre Dame. I would say I had a complete game, offense and defensively, and I would say Notre Dame.
What are you going to miss the most about playing in Poly?
The fans. They mean a lot to me. Coming in the United States was, a difficult thing for me to do, because, it's not easy to leave friends and family behind and come to a place that you don't know anybody and you don't know what to expect. And having the fans there to support and, scream and cheer, that really helped me adjust and, get comfortable.
And what do you think are you going to miss the most about UCLA as an institution?
Just the people. I don't think if it's just a UCLA thing, but people here are great. They're ready to help you anything you need. That's just on the basketball side of it. Yeah. And academically, I think I'll miss a lot. All the professors here are very caring people, and I love getting to class and enjoy the whole experience. So I'll miss that part.
Reflecting on all your 4 years at UCLA, what do you think was your favorite individual moment?
Gonzaga. Just straight out Gonzaga. When we beat Gonzaga that year, I think that really solidified, us being one of the elite teams, and it carried over in the next 2 years.
And out of your 4 seasons, which one do you think was your favorite?
Which was my favorite game?
Season.
Season? Wow, they was all real good. There's not one in particular that was just my favorite. Every season was really special to me.
Obviously, your senior night ended a little bit early. What was your thoughts as you were leaving the building for the final time? What was going through your head?
Just thinking about the first time, I came to Poly Pavilion, and I never thought it would be after 4 years, I'd be here and enjoying, the fans, my coaching staff, my teammates, and it's been real special.
What are you going to miss most about playing in Poly?
The fans, how they always get on our case when we lose games. They be hard on us, and just being around a lot of legendary players and which that ever coached the game, John Wooden.
clock is down to five. Get it in for Schmidt. Turns, fires, and connects. Honey. Lee looks down low. Bias came out defensively. Pretty clean. 1-25. Oh, Stover just rejected it. Honey cut the drive, and the foul call. Stover didn't even have to extend his arm.
That was a SWAT team. Oh, look at this. The little guy thinks he's getting by with this. I don't think so. Not so much.
Wow. Anthony Stover is the only player in the country with more than 20 blocks. Lee exploding to the...
And a terrific move just then. Nice hands. Good job by Honeycutt. Look up the floor. He got one.
Moves it ahead for Lee, who lays it in. The defensive rebound. Get it up the floor in a hurry. Parsons! Honeycutt with the block! Oh, Honeycutt!
Little sweet defense right there, Ian, because transition defense, which Ben Howland wanted his squad to do.
This is a six-point game with under 5 minutes left. Pull up, pop for three. Honeycutt, he drains it. Terrific look. Five remaining here in Tampa. Honeycutt a three, knocks it down.
Baby.
He's looking to catch his breath.
Honeycutt for Schmidt. Inside, yes.
Good smarts, real good smarts. That's the
left. Concern over that left ankle. Wilbekin trying to get it in. He'll go deep.
Whoa.
Caught by Walker. Lee went for the steal. Walker. Oh, he's lethal. Walker.
One difference between UCLA this year and seasons past is they have a faster tempo. We knew that. We talked a lot about it. But the number of different players they have that can thrive in transition can really give you problems. And that was part of our slow start tonight.
about defensively, what do you need to slow these guys down a little bit?
UCLA is a very good team, Dana, and one of the things we talked a lot about is how fast they play. I don't want to say it caught us off guard, but they thrive in it, and in the first half, they did a great job. And, you know, as you're behind by so many in a game that's at home, you start to play differently, and, you know, we weren't ourselves in the first half, and credit UCLA.
57 with 10 seconds left. We'll see if UCLA calls a timeout. Nope, Howland says go. Drew with 3 seconds left. Drew with two. Fall away, Jay. Hit it! UCLA wins at the buzzer. Larry Drew, the star of the night. He clearly got it off in time. And UCLA ends a two-game losing streak.
Just like they drew it up. Everything falling in place for the UCLA Bruins, who stay within one game of the league-leading Arizona Wildcats with this magnificent performance tonight. Drew two. The players up the court. Confusion, hesitation, doubt. Larry Drew waves them all off, comes off the pick over the top, steps right in with that right foot. The perfect execution in your face, and nothing that the Washington Huskies can do about it.
Special. Someone asked that up in Seattle. I can't remember who, but everyone is special that you win as a coach, because this is something, you know, and you know, the regular season's over now. Now we're on to the funnest part of the year, but in terms of winning a conference championship, that's something that those kids will all share the rest of our lives. And you don't have perspective on that as an 18, 19, 20-year-old, but when they're 40, you know, it'll be fun for them to be able to really reflect upon how special it is. I think that you know, the reflecting part is years now, years away, to really appreciate it. It's like you see this when you have our former players come back and they're around. I mean, there's just so much joy in their hearts, because this was the greatest time of their life, being a part of this program and playing for Coach Wooden and playing for the different coaches, Cunningham or Larry, all the different players that come back, you know, for Coach Herrick. And, but all those guys growing up, and when you come back, you don't appreciate how special it is until you're older and you get a chance to look back and reflect. It's like, wow, that was unbelievably special, you know? So it's always wonderful. No, I appreciate it more. That's why, because I am 55 years old, I have a little more perspective. So, you know, the appreciation of going through tough years and then bouncing back and getting a championship does make it special. You know, in tough years, we've won four of the last eight Pac-12 championships, and we finished second in two of the years that we didn't win it. So, you know, it's been pretty good.
silky smooth attacking style to the rim, and he's headed to the free throw line.
Spiro, we told you before, Kyle Anderson's known as slow-mo.
Answer. 1 point lead for the Bruins. Nasty finish with a right hand.
Norman Powell, we told you about how good an athlete he is. He just debos Lloyd and to the bucket, little Kung Powell chicken. Tony Wood.
Full head of steam as the Ducks look to push tempo. Let's call the card. What a pass inside as they thread the needle to Powell.
As you watch Kyle Anderson, you see Norman Powell streaking, and a bounce pass is just hard for the defense to recover. That is beautiful touch.
Well, this is an emotional day for Artis as Muhammad goes backdoor. Hard finish with both hands.
Back of zone. You got to get to the heart of the zone. Jordan Adams, heart of the zone, top of the key. Travis Ware has become an outstanding 18-foot jump shooter. They find him in transition. He finds his own shot, faking a handoff. On balance, in rhythm.
Kuzemi double. Dangerous pass stolen by Muhammad. Two on one, left side, Adams, and he's fouled.
So much better for the Bruins.
Thank you. Drew. Beautiful dribble on Paul. Lefty won't go. There's David Ware to tip it in the lead. Back to six for UCLA.
Their point guard played a great, great game. His 9 assists don't reflect on how he dominated the game. I would say he had probably 4 or 5 other plays that his pass led to a foul. And so that's not an assist, but we had no answer for him. And he picked us apart. He's a really, really good player. He's the perfect point guard for their team because he makes everybody better. And I thought you really felt that watching the game tonight.
Defense. How would you describe what you've seen so far?
UCLA is a hard team to guard.
there are times where we played well, but they're very difficult to guard. I think the story for us is just 9 turnovers. I believe that's what we had. And, you know, on the road, 9 turnovers is difficult to overcome. If we take care of the ball better in the second half, we have a chance.
Outside of turnovers, what is UCLA doing that requires the most adjustment for you at halftime?
You know, I don't know if it's one thing. They can really spread you out. You know, at the 5 position, they have a face-up player in Travis Ware, and Kyle Anderson's terrific. You know, really at all 5 positions, they're very good on offense. And, you know, like I mentioned, Larry Drew, he's difficult to deal with, especially if he can score, because he's the engine that makes them go.
Thanks, Coach. We appreciate it.
Cameron, it's a special night for everybody who stays for 4 years. A big hug with Ben Howland. His family is here.
Well, especially for Larry Drew, the season that he's had in guiding this UCLA team to what is assured as an NCAA tournament bid. And he plays with such great pace. He's been a terrific leader for this team.
As Ware goes straight to the basket to quiet him down early here in Seattle.
Well, if you're going to beat UCLA, this is not Ben Howland's previous team. They like to run. They lead the conference in scoring, 23rd in the country. And Travis Ware, showing no ill effects from that sprained foot, has Kyle Anderson slow-mo throwing the ball up in transition.
UCLA won in their last meeting on a last-second shot by Drew Two. Good look to Muhammad. Have to win the conference tournament to make it to the NCAA tournament this season. They come in at 9-8 in conference play and 17-13 overall. Slow-mo getting it done at the rim.
He is the most appropriately nicknamed player in college basketball. Kyle Anderson from New Jersey is nicknamed Slow-mo. That's as fast as he goes, that's as slow as he goes. It's only one speed, but it's really effective.
Yeah, just as smooth as it gets. Ware, beautiful post move underneath, and he's out to a good start, Travis Ware. Shot clock winding down, Gaddy's got to get one up, great defense by Drew. Five, and Drew Two comes up with a big basket for the Bruins. And there's Adams again, a rainmaker. Jordan Adams, he averages just over 15 a game, the freshman from Atlanta. Wilcox, and a whistle going the other way, a charge on C.J. Wilcox.
Excellent play from Kyle Anderson.
Adams, nifty. Adams finishes at the rim.
They can't guard Jordan Adams. Shabazz Muhammad catching the ball in the low post and beasting C.J. Wilcox and then driving Scott Suggs to the basket. Then Jordan Adams getting loose, hitting a jump shot, taking it to the rack. And the two freshmen, Brian Anderson, have combined for 23 of the Bruins' 40 points.
Getting off to a good start, and nobody counts on their freshmen more than UCLA in the nation.
And we just got a chance to see Kentucky, who, like in the movie Princess Bride, they're not dead. They were mostly dead, which means somewhat alive. And UCLA, very much alive in their quest to become Pac-12 champions.
Side. And David Ware, what a great pass from Drew, too.
Wide open. You got to battle. You got to claw. You got to fight. You got to want it. Bruins down two late.
Well, I thought Kyle Anderson's biggest challenge was Andrew Andrews, but it wasn't. It was Shabazz Muhammad after the miss. Muhammad with the active hands on his own guy.
You gotta want it. I mean, look, you know Shabazz Muhammad's a scorer. The guy's played 25 games, he got 24 assists. He ain't passing.
Game was decided on a Larry Drew buzzer beater. The end, it was Drew two. Now they get into their stuff here, under 10 on the shot clock. Drew two with take, and Larry Drew, just like he did in early February, it's a big bucket, this time on the attack. And the Bruins by five.
Now we're at the home of Starbucks, right? Coffee is for closers. Coffee being served in Westwood.
Washington down five, and that's
stripped
away.
What a play from Larry Drew.
Larry Drew on the defensive end. And that's going to send Powell to the line, and Larry Drew coming up big again against the Huskies.
Let me explain my infatuation with what Larry Drew is doing his senior year. I was that guy. I transferred. I couldn't hit a shot. You lose total confidence. He was a high school McDonald's All-American. And you know what? He's recovered his confidence, and he's winning a Pac-12 title with two great defensive plays and essentially the game-sealing bucket. Hit the game-winner against Washington at home. That's incredible. Considering the hype surrounding Larry Drew, how it ended at North Carolina, and how he walked out in the Carolina team, and then Kendall Marshall became a star, had to sit a year and a half, struggled early on this season. Heck, I said on CBS, I didn't think they had a good enough point guard to win the Pac-12. Great stuff from Larry Drew.
And on a day when Larry Drew takes over as the single-season assist record holder in UCLA basketball history, six assists today. He comes up with a huge defensive play after a made basket on the other end. And UCLA up seven. And Washington gonna have an 8-year streak snapped here today. For the first time since 2004, UCLA has come into Seattle and they have beaten the Washington Huskies, and they will share a regular season Pac-12 title.
Well, it'll look like just a regular win, right? It just looked like a win over a non-NCAA tournament team. But you win a Pac-12 title, we'll see them in March Madness.
So long from Seattle.
With a rebound. Bruins need to get up the court in transition here. What a great long, low bounce pass by Drew to Powell. Wow, Travis Ware saves the day. After Lyons put on a great spin. And then David Ware.
That ball was blocked in the recovery by David Ware. The Twins exhibiting the Twin Tower offense for the Bruins.
To Travis Ware.
Beautiful basketball.
looks like a little discombobulation, but it's all set up on the, out of the timeout there at the back screen. Looking for the guy who set the screen, and the Wildcats break down defensively with a nice throwdown, but most importantly, the picture-perfect pass.
Time of game for UCLA, and as you said, look where they are at 40. If Muhammad can add, yes, he can. Muhammad with a terrific finish and one.
Stars shining brightly on this trip in Las Vegas. Careless, sloppy basketball, thinking it's over. This game is far from over.
Flying in. Muhammad again finishes and one. Wow, two excellent makes by Muhammad.
This is what UCLA needs from Shabazz Muhammad from the opening tip. That undeniable determination to get the job done, however it plays out. ...15 late in this game, and then it all turns around. The Sun Devils snatching defeat from the jaws of victory. Kyle Anderson down the lane, jumpers left and right, Travis Ware, David Ware, you name it. Turnovers, missed jumpers, only one player getting it done.
And Bill, I think in unison we could say, and I ask... Too strong, that's stolen. What a play by Jordan Adams. And Adams for two. And here we go, two-point game.
The poise of UCLA, Shabazz Muhammad, Jordan Adams are both in the rhythm and zone right now. And nobody for Arizona's got anything going. The only thing the Wildcats have in their favor is a two-point lead at this moment.
One thing that UCLA has done, they've possessed the ball well. Only five turnovers tonight, Bill.
Jordan Adams has been superb in all aspects. Ill-advised play, Kevin Parham underneath the basket. And then nobody gets back. Jordan Adams just pulls up the bank shot, which UCLA memorialized as this is what we're going to get because we can make this shot because that's what we practice.
And Adams with a huge response. Adams is going nuts here in the second half.
Net right now, and then Jordan Adams immediately, early in the shot clock, that guy's in the zone. Get him the ball a lot.
Adams with a crazy shot and he makes it. Wow. You do get the idea. This is the way the players, especially the UCLA players, love the game. They love this.
I love this game.
Back and forth. Everything on the line. History, legacy, tradition, what the Pac-12 is all about.
And now Solomon Hill has the ball, late clock. Tarzewski set him the screen, but Hill down underneath.
The loose balls are all going for UCLA.
Foul. Oh, Muhammad went down trying to rebound, and Arizona. Lions is called.
Up and down action, finally. Solomon Hill just says, there is nothing you can do about this. That's in your face. Then Jordan Adams right back with a seemingly impossible shot. Oh my.
going to go. Sets up Adams. No, Anderson! Kyle Anderson! UCLA has been pounded on the boards all night, but with 22 seconds left, Kyle Anderson with a huge offensive rebound.
Arizona gets back into it on their last touch. It goes for a pump fake inexplicably. The dribble penetration, the defense just has to collapse. Then Jared has that nice stroke and the willingness to let it fly. And then Arizona seemingly back in control and with a life once again. But when you give up a three-point shot and inside position, what is your reason to make us believe that you deserve to win this game?
Well, now the utter identity of Ben Howland's teams at UCLA has been defense. And this is where this group of players, and these are players who had to try to embrace defense this year, now they need one defensive stand.
UCLA doesn't really have any lockdown defensive forces individually. They do it as a team. Seconds. The fate of the world.
Mark Lyons. Well, he'll fake the three. And he'll the tip. UCLA! Three times over Arizona. Regular season, and tomorrow they'll play for the tournament championship. Yogi?
Thanks, guys. Coach, down 15 yesterday, down 11 today. Speak to your team.
You know what? I wish we weren't getting down so much, but I'm just so proud of their resilience, the way they never give up, they fight back. It says a lot about the character of the kids in our program.
How about your three big freshmen? Only 12 points at half. They finished with 45 combined. Talk about those three players.
Well, I thought Jordan Adams really took the game over when we were making our comeback in terms of making plays, the steal, the free throws. Everything he did was incredible. Shabazz had a much better second half. Kyle makes the big rebound and puts it in at the end of the game there for us. So they've been stepping up big all year, but everybody contributes. It's a huge win.
What's it going to be like for this team getting to the finals of the inaugural Pac-12 tournament in Las Vegas?
We're very excited about it. We'll live, play another day. We know it's going to be a tough game. We need all the rest we can muster right now to get ready for it.
Well, go enjoy it, Coach. We'll see you tomorrow night. Back to Ted.
The players have to find their legs tomorrow. The coach has to find his voice.
What a game. What an experience. What a moment. And the UCLA faithful just having the time of their life.
Oh, wish the world could see the smile on your face when you see a finish to a high-level basketball game.
What a great game. Back and forth, and everybody just going for it. And how happy they are on one side and how dejected and disappointed. But UCLA moves on to the championship. Oh, my gosh, they're the number one seed. They were not favored to win the regular season. They won that. They were not favored to win this. They won so far. They will be favored tomorrow night.
It was obviously a great college basketball game. I want to give complete and total credit to UCLA. They fought hard. They have tremendous talent. They're very well coached. And they make huge plays. We went into this game determined not to let Larry Drew beat us the way he beat us in the first and second game, and really mission accomplished. Not that he didn't play an excellent game, but they went about it a different way. Jordan Adams really stepped up, and they made big plays, and that's what March is about, making big plays.
Well, thanks to all of you for being here. I want to start off by thanking Chancellor Block, Chancellor Abrams, and Chancellor Carnesow, who was the chancellor who hired me 10 years ago, for giving me the extraordinary opportunity to work and represent the greatest university in the world. I'm so proud to have been a part of the Bruin family and feel honored and privileged have been at UCLA these past 10 years. I'm especially thankful to Dan Guerrero, who hired me and who I've worked with closely throughout my 10 years. I can't thank him enough for the opportunity he gave me, and I enjoyed our working relationship, his support, and his regard for all that we've accomplished. I wish Dan continued success in sustaining the premier athletic program in the country. And during my tenure at UCLA, I've been so blessed to coach so many wonderful young men. I've been given the opportunity to work with some of the greatest players in the history of UCLA basketball. And I love them. I care about them very much, and care about their lives, and will be there for them the rest of my life. The pride of being a Bruin is something that will always be a part of who I am. And I've helped our players come to recognize the same feeling and pride of being a part of this great, historic tradition of UCLA basketball. This recognition has been very special for me, and I have always emphasized how incredible it is to be a part of this program and this university. One of my greatest joys as a coach, as an in coach feels, is the relationship with your players and your former players. And being a part of their lives is something that's special and dear to me. And they're lifelong relationships. I have players that I coached back when I started in this business 32 years ago. It's amazing. They're 49 years old now. And I started really young, so I was very blessed. But such bonds are forged through tremendous effort, sacrifice, unselfishness, dedication. And I'm indebted to all the past and present players for all they've given to UCLA basketball and to me as their coach.